Does your bathroom have a medicine cabinet? Do you keep medicines in it? Because, fun fact, this basic architectural reality of many homes invites us to store our medications in the worst possible place. Heat and humidity are the enemies of most common medications. Luckily, most of the time, the consequences are mild. Except for that one time when it might have been really bad. Like, really bad. We'll get there. If you keep your medicine in the bathroom, you are not alone. I certainly do. Maybe it helps you remember to take your meds if you see them every time you brush your teeth, or maybe it's just the most convenient place. But bathrooms are not the best place to store medicine. Lots of drugs degrade when they are exposed to light, heat, or humidity. The light part is actually why medicine bottles are like brown colored, so that not all the light gets through. It's like they have sunglasses on. If anybody in your household, like, I don't know, takes hot showers, the chances are your bathroom hits at least one of those criteria. Now, it's not like scientists are not aware of this problem. It is a stunningly dull job, but there are people who monitor the long-term stability of medicines before and after they hit the market. Basically, you stick the medicine in these big chambers meant to mimic the conditions of your average Florida afternoon, like some dark, twisted reflection of a refrigerator. Then you pull some of it out every now and again to make sure it's all still there, or if it started to degrade. And while, yes, this is a boring job, I used to work in a quality control laboratory, somebody has to do it, because we want our vitamins and pain relievers to still work even if the AC goes out for a few days. This information is where expiration dates come from. And what we learn from these kinds of experiments is that storing your medicine under too warm or too humid conditions is usually not the end of the world. Your medicine might go bad before the expiration date, or it might lose a bit of its potency, but still work okay. Take insulin, for example. Insulin becomes less effective when it's stored at temperatures above 30 degrees Celsius. But some sources say that you can still use it in an emergency. Lidocaine also remains stable after 6 months at 40 degrees Celsius. Most over the counter medications are designed to be stable at or close to room temperature. But you cannot exactly guess based on the kind of medication. Consider four common pain relievers: acetaminophen, aka Tylenol, ibuprofen, aka Advil, naproxen, aka Aleve, and aspirin, aka aspirin. You'd think that all of these would be the same, especially Advil, Aleve, and aspirin, because they all belong to the same class of drug, and they all start with A. And yet, Advil and Tylenol work best when they are kept between 20 and 25 degrees Celsius. Meanwhile, aspirin and Aleve are a little hardier and can tolerate temperatures between 15 and 30 degrees. And that's just regular tablets, before you get into stuff like liquid capsules and stuff. I know, check the label, ask your pharmacist, don't go based on vibes. Sometimes improper storage conditions can have mild downsides. For example, consider aspirin again. Aspirin slowly breaks down into two other compounds, acetate and salicylic acid. Acetate plus water makes acetic acid, otherwise known as vinegar, which will not hurt anything in small amounts, but also will not do much for your headache. Salicylic acid might still offer some pain relief. Ancient Sumerians extracted it from willow bark and used it as one of the very first painkillers, but it can be hard on your stomach. We also could not confirm whether or not it works as a blood thinner if you're on an aspirin regimen for your heart. So, if you open your aspirin bottle and get a whiff of vinegar, probably time to toss it out. But every once in a while, storing medicine improperly turns out to be dangerous, which means we need to talk about ranitidine.
Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this SciShow video. Brilliant is an online learning platform with thousands of lessons in computer science, math, and science, like their latest courses all about data. You can gain introductory skills in data analysis or level up your learning with Brilliant. They have options for every level of background knowledge that you might be coming in with. So whether you start with Bayes' theorem or multiple linear regression, there's always more to learn next. In Brilliant's courses, you get to explore data visually, make educated predictions with the power of probability, and create models with multiple variables. And that's just the data courses. Don't get me started on programming, but you can get started programming when you check them out at brilliant.org/scishow or the link in the description down below. That link also gives you 20% off an annual premium Brilliant subscription, and you'll get your first 30 days for free.
Ranitidine, which was sold under the brand name Zantac, is a heartburn medicine. If you're a heartburn type of person, you may have noticed that Zantac disappeared from shelves back in 2020. That's because the FDA was informed that a chemical called N-nitrosodimethylamine, or NDMA, builds up over time in medicines that contain ranitidine. NDMA is classified as a probable human carcinogen, a substance that might cause cancer. It also occurs naturally at low concentrations in water and foods like grilled meat. At low levels, it's not a cause for concern, but at higher concentrations, it could increase your risk of developing cancer. So just so we're clear though, you, the consumer, are not responsible for making sure your medicine doesn't decay into a carcinogen, even if you do keep it next to the shower. Regulatory agencies like the FDA exist to make sure medicines are safe, and the FDA launched a full investigation once they learned this might occur. The FDA found that NDMA will build up in ranitidine medicines over time, regardless of temperature. But NDMA accumulates faster when ranitidine is stored at higher temperatures, including temperatures that it might encounter en route to pharmacies or when it is stored at home. Several companies issued a voluntary recall on ranitidine while the FDA investigated the issue in 2019. Then, in April 2020, the FDA asked manufacturers to pull ranitidine off the market. Regulatory agencies in the European Union and Australia followed soon after. Regulators found that the amount of NDMA that builds up in ranitidine products could exceed the acceptable daily intake limit, the amount that has been shown to cause adverse effects. For NDMA, that's about 96 billionths of a gram per day. There is some good news, though. The FDA pulled ranitidine to be on the safe side, and a 2023 study found that ranitidine use was not associated with higher cancer rates. Now, that could change, but there's no reason to scare you if we don't know. Plus, NDMA doesn't build up in other heartburn medicines like Prilosec and Nexium, so there are other options for managing heartburn. Also, Zantac, turns out, is back on the market. It's just a different drug with the same brand name, so it should be all right. Zantac people, please don't sue us. Again, even if you kept your Zantac in the hottest, muggiest, most swamp-like bathroom in your house, it's not your fault that this happens. We included it because it's like the exception that proves the rule. Usually, if your meds get a little toasty, they are fine. And we know that because there was a time that it wasn't fine and the system in place caught it and stopped it. If you would like to be extra sure you are storing your medicine safely, here are some steps you can take. Keep your medicine in a cool, dark, and dry place out of reach of children and pets. Depending on your situation, a closet, dresser, drawer, or kitchen cabinet away from the stove might be good choices. If there isn't anywhere that works other than the bathroom, run that fan during and after showers to keep the humidity low. Also, take out any cotton balls that come with your medicine bottle. Cotton soaks up moisture from the air, and that water then gets trapped in the bottle and can break down medicines over time. It's there in the first place so that the pills don't rattle around and break. So that's if you don't need it anymore once it's at home. Dispose of any medicines that have changed color, consistency, or smell, and check with your pharmacist for instructions on how to safely get rid of old medicines. Sometimes they'll even let you drop off certain pills with them. And also, if you are still hanging on to any old Zantac or other medicine with ranitidine, it's time to throw that out and ask your doctor about alternatives. It's probably a good thing that most medicines don't turn into anything harmful when you store them under less than perfect conditions, because humans are often less than perfect. I know I am. That's just how we are. So it's a big help when science can cover the gaps.